Welcome to our YouTube channel. In today's lesson, we are going to be learning one of the CSS properties, which is the list properties. We are going to understand how to make use of list properties in our CSS in designing our website. If you like this kind of content, do well by joining our YouTube channel, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and also turn on the notification button to know when we are going to post our new videos. We are going to go in details to understand the CSS properties. CSS list properties is used in designing our listing, whereby you want a user to come into your website to select an option which you have already displayed on your website. That is when you make use of your list. We have two types of lists, which is the UL and the OL. The UL is the unordered list, while the OL is ordered list. An ordered list in the sense that once you make use of an ordered list, it's going to come out in your website, like it's going to come out in a dotted form. It's not going to come out in numbers. But if you make use of ordered list, it's going to come out in numbers. But in this class, we're going to be making use of an ordered list. Inside your unordered list, which is the UL, once you write your UL tag, inside your UL tag, you write your LI type tag, which is the list tag. Inside your list tag, that's when you list the options you want the user to select in your website. Let's list, we listed bags, we listed clothes, we listed shoes. This is what we're going to use in designing our listing. So let's run it and see how it's going to be displayed on our browser. If you run it, so it's going to be displayed like this because we make use of an ordered list. It's going to come out in a dotted line, dotted line options. So this is going to come out in a dotted line. So we're going to use our list properties now to design our listing. So we're going to do our first listing, which is the list style type. List style type in the sense that if you want to remove the styles in your list, you don't like the styles, don't want it to display like that in your website, and you want to remove it, what are you going to do? First of all, go into your CSS. Call whatever you want to design, which is our UL. We want to design our UL. So we write our list style type. Let's say none, because we want to remove that list type automatically. We don't want it to display like that. We don't want it to be like that. So we want to remove it. So once you run it on your browser, it will remove automatically. Basically, this list type is always found whenever you want to design your navbar and you make use of listing in your navbar. So once you design your navbar, basically these dotted lines will come. Sometimes it will be in a straight line, so it comes on a dotted line. So once it comes out and you want to remove it automatically, make use of list type, which is none. Another list properties which we are going to be learning in this class, we are going to learn our list type position. If you want to position your listing, you can position your list inside, outside, inherit, depending on how you want to do it. And another one is list type image. Whenever you want to put image in your listing, before you do that, make sure you have an image folder in your website folder where you design your website. If you don't have it already, you can go to your system, create an image folder inside your email, inside the folder you are already using to design your website. Create an image folder, copy the images in your laptop, paste it inside that image folder, rename it so that whenever it comes into the place that you design your website, whenever it comes in there and you just call that image, the image will come out automatically. Let's say we have our list type image. You say URL. Then inside your URL, you can call the image. You can call the image folder. So this is my own image folder. I save it. So make sure the image folder you are calling, make sure it's the name that you gave your image folder that you are calling. So this is the image that comes out. This is the image that comes out if you call the image. This is the image that comes out, because we're still going to learn how to design our images. The image is not going to look like this. So this is the image that will come out whenever you put an image as a listing in your